Yeah, here, welcome to the commentary of the Split 3 AOR race here in Spa-Francorchamps. I don't know if that's pronounced correctly. But here today it's Vice Guy Stealing and ISMU.
Hello.
Hello.
And in a couple of seconds we're gonna cut over to the qualifying where ISMU is gonna comment on the 2-1 of the pole lap and some down in the middle.
So here we have a qualifying comparison between Stelling DK and ISMU. And we're going to see that both of them are doing their laps quite late in the session. Isamusing locking up there down into La Source. Now we've got a long downhill straight-ish into Eau Rouge, which is a magnificent corner, which you have to get right and carry the maximum speed up to the Kennel Straight. And now we've got to take as much speed, both cars in seventh gear. We can see Stelling getting onto the grass there for some reason. Long Kennel Straight. Eyes amusing going for short gears now down into Les Combes, and we've got to get as much speed through here as well. This track is much about taking speed through the corners and getting the braking points right. As you can see, Eyes amusing already creating a gap here on his qualifying lap, where Stelling's having a bit of problems through the corners, I think understeer, and we've got a noticeable difference now down into Puhong, and Stelling lifts off a bit more than Isamusing again, so there's a bit of problems. There was very much a race that was looking like it was going to rain, so Stelling obviously going for a setup for the rain, Isamusing taking the setup for the dry to get qualified. Isamusing is up on purple sector, so that means up on everybody, but he's lying in 12th, so he needs to get this qualifying lap absolutely perfect. And we're coming up now to the chicane that is the most crucial corner in the circuit, because you can lose a lot of time here getting wheel spin. And Stelling getting a bit of time back there in that last sector, but Isamusing gets a better start, and there we go. So Isamusing qualifies first, followed by Winters with 0.44 between them, with Ify third, Altazil fourth, Sunnable fifth, and Stelling sixth. That rounds up the top six, and we're going to cut now to the race.
Yeah, as we see, it's winning, and the guys are starting out full wet, so this is going to be very interesting to see how they will.
Yeah. Also, Isamusing had some kind of engine failure or something like that, so he won't be participating in the race, so there will be no one in the pole from this.
Yep, also clear blow to his championship there, as he's going to have to fight hard in the next races. Anyway, here we go, lights out and away we go. As you can see, Stelling getting a good start compared to Altazil there. Sunnable taking an opportunity to get up the inside. And there's,
there's massive chaos and Broadway spins around.
Oh, and Broadway is spinning.
Yep, looks like the side pod glitch. And looks
maybe
like
a
Stelling's
bit of
got jumped by Sunnable.
It was actually looking, if you are looking very close to Stelling DK's screen, he was not noticing the Armstrong up and up on his right side, so that could be dangerous for Armstrong, because Stelling DK could have smashed him into the wall. But if you also are noticing, Stelling DK's engine are a little bit overheated.
You can see here that Vice Guy is having a struggle with Altazil. Vice spin. And he couldn't follow him.
The racing here, but Sunnable's going to have to try and get away from Stelling if he doesn't want to lose a place there. Stelling gets massive oversteer on that corner. Obviously, the wet weather setup not working as intended at the moment, but he's got to try and keep that engine cool. But I think the wet weather won't be as much of a problem.
I think the track was just totally soaked. I think it didn't matter what setup you had, it was just way too wet to even be driving. Everyone is struggling from the back mirrors to the front. So
yeah, the drivers.
Stelling
into the gravel. No, Stelling.
Oh,
no. It was some.
It was some more wind gravel.
Oh, not Stelling. Some more. Oh Christ, I got that wrong.
Yeah, clearly. That is going to be crucial for Son of More's race. If he, depending on how many places he lit through there. So also I think the Stelling case from Sturdy was staying a little bit more behind Son of More, so his engine not will overheat.
Now that's not a problem. And I think the next guy up the road is Winters. It is.
Oh!
Massive oversteer. And that's lost him a lot of time, and he's under threat now from Armstrong into Las Source.
Also, Wallocks. Wallocks
is quite close.
Oh!
Oh, Locks up goes wide again. This isn't the start.
Yeah, right behind him.
He's got a better exit, though, so that's probably going to secure his position in there. He's got a lot of curves as well. Start of the lap.
Yeah,
looks like it'll be okay.
Yeah, clearly no grip on this track so far for the guys.
Wallocks coming back, though.
Yeah.
This looks like...
Oh!
Looks like it's going to be a pass. Is it? Armstrong's coming back at him as well. It might be three wide into the corner. Stelling defends. Armstrong goes for an opportunistic move, but he doesn't make it. And as we can see, Winters is making a very big gap.
Oh, we can see Weisker here being in a bit of a trouble. Just followed by Yodag and punching down.
Yeah, clearly also fighting with his teammate.
Now it's Son of Mor in 8th place. Son of Mor must have been inside in the pits.
Yeah.
Also, notice the tire wear on the rear tires. That might be a problem in the next couple of laps.
Yeah.
I think the problem.
Oh, a little bit of wheelbang.
Bit of a dive bombing from Yoda.
The McLaren's recreating what happens in real life between two McLarens.
Yeah. Well, as we cut to a lap two. Well,
we're gonna see it from the inside of the McLaren.
Yeah.
Oh.
Just out braking himself.
Yeah.
He nowhere to go.
And, the vice guy comes past again.
He gives the place back.
Yeah, I think that was a fair move.
Oh, he's coming under threat from Broadway.
Wow, that is a leg spike.
Oh, the amusing connection was bad. There's proof that I don't have the worst internet.
I think the problem is that it's American connecting to a European. That might not be so good. I think that's why he was lagging so bad.
Well, still, that was an amazing leg spike going on there.
That was definitely out of normal, and I don't think Red Bull can manage to match that kind of technology.
No,
just literally not. Oh, it actually seems like... Oh, that's guy got quiet! Oh, it's Vice Guy!
Oh, another collision!
Again! Wow!
Yodak just didn't keep inside on the inside line, did he?
Seems like Yodak was...
It looked like he was trying to go a bit wide, Yoda.
Breaking himself, and there he goes.
Doesn't leave enough space. I would say that.
It was half and half, really, I think.
Yeah, I think Vice Guy gave back the spot to Yoda just to be fair.
Yeah. Well, as we cut to Yoda again, and what's. Oh, that car! Oh,
he's following Broadway up into the gravel.
Wow.
Broadway and Yodog. There goes Vice Guy.
Oh!
He was fresh.
Like a boss. And that is probably the end of Broadway's fight.
This is the same video again from Vice Guy. Ooh, it's so cool.
That is. Oh!
Oh, that was just
up.
It doesn't seem like Broadway was paying attention to Vice Guy coming from behind, so it does like. Yeah, I'm turning into this way again without coming behind me, and then Vice Guy coming from the gun and giving him the middle pick.
It looks like Winters is creating more of a gap as Stelling battles with Warlock.
Yeah. As we also are at lap 3 now. That is...
Nice pass, but it looks like Stelling going to cut him off, and that's the pass done again. But it looks like his tires are taking a bit of a beating with the tire wear.
Five. Whoa!
Very lucky to get away with that.
I think the wind survived.
Yeah, that was clearly something of the Red Bull technology again.
Reinforced steel in the front wing.
Yeah, as we of course blocks get through caused a little bit of a driver issue.
Wide, so that gives the place back to Stelling as long as he can keep it, but Stelling having a lot of problems with grip at the moment. Looks like Winters is going to walk away with it from this point in the race, but obviously we have no idea what's going to happen after.
Oh, there's a FC 7.3 seconds gap between Winters and Stelling PK, so it seems like Winters just are driving his own race now. And
But then again, one mistake and Stelling is up to him next to him again.
In these type of conditions, it's very easy to make a mistake. And really, with everybody running a dry setup from qualifying, it doesn't look like it's the best.
Again. Oh, it seems like the same situation again. Oh, and Warlock outbreaks himself.
And he outbreaks himself for the third time.
If you're listening, you can hear a little bit of the tire screaming as we cut to lap 7 with Waska.
And look at that tire wear.
Yeah, those tires are just completely destroyed. As you can see, he's trying to break into the car.
He's in the barrier. There goes the front wing. Lucky to not destroy the tire there as well. And watch out though, there's a car coming up.
I don't think he looked in the mirrors at that point.
No, he didn't look in the mirrors, but he got away with it.
Yelling into the wall, like also well, interesting to see a driver driving without a front wing into the pit lane, and also locking up.
And it looks like that's going to put him near the back of the field. In fact, there's only about three cars behind him.
I think there is.
Okay, so here we go, out of the pit exit. And he'll want to get a good line now down through Aarhus. Can he get that line?
Probably not.
Yeah, it looks pretty good.
That's looked pretty good. As we got to level 8. Well, nearly level 9 now.
Winters looks like he's pitted, going for the undercut.
Stelling a little bit of a weird entrance to the pit, but
weird entrance, but it looks like it's fast.
Yeah,
but it also looks like Winters is probably going to overtake him pretty easily.
Yeah, they were, and Warlock's also just kept running.
Yeah, and you
will need to go to pit later.
Yeah, of course, going to the wet again and going down to lean and the pit stop. Actually, a quite good pit stop for Force Indias.
So Winters probably has a gap of around 10 to 15 seconds, possibly.
Yeah. Oh, and you're fighting with that is Armstrong coming through the first corner. And you have a nice day, not wide behind him, but 20 seconds, that's...
And again, he's catching up in the start because he ran wide and he throttled.
Yeah, well, it's going to be interesting to see if Sin K can follow Armstrong, also depend on when...
Can he actually make the pass?
Hitting.
Can he make the pass?
This is...
It looks like he's trying to pressure you into a mistake.
Didn't get through, so...
Now let's see what happens through Brussels here. It's a notoriously difficult corner to break for, and Stelling gets it wrong.
It seems like a little bit of a lock out there in the tires.
Yeah.
And also a little bit of a mistake from Armstrong, so that really doesn't matter for the guys.
Stelling losing time.
Yeah. Actually taking this game, not this game, but the turn very well there.
Yeah, it looks like he's got the speed to overtake Armstrong, he just has to find the place to get past.
Yeah, well maybe it will come now, we will see on...
Maybe down the straight or into the pain.
Armstrong going a little up.
Space, and that was a magnificent pass.
He's
in gravel again. Second time.
Maybe we should create
an award for the amount of time spent in the gravel.
Can he maybe come through there? He's struggling a little bit there.
Lucky to get away with that one.
Even though he's tired on you and the temperature is...
Yeah, well, his severe tires are still a lot of coal. Well, as we cut to a lap 10 now, and
Winter's lapping about a second faster. We saw he did a 1:57.
And
there goes Armstrong going
through again.
So he's gonna have to pass again.
There is clearly a battle going on between Stanley UK and Armstrong there for the second place. That is sure.
But if you also noticed, Stelling's tires were losing temperature, but they look fine now.
Yeah, as we are of course cutting to lap 12 again, and
I think it depends on where on the track he is.
Yeah, there's some spot.
Lag spike, nearly. I think. Lag bubble, maybe? I don't know.
Hit
the barrier! Exactly the same as in Hungaroring.
Yeah, clearly he can't control the cars.
Really, he's just, pushing too hard for his ability.
Yeah. Well, of course, we all know that drives for the tricycle over with 100% as they can do as we are.
Here we are with Joe Dark. Let's see what he's doing. I think he's coming to the pit.
Well, it's his lap 11.
And one thing I must try and point out is that frame rate must not be easy to drive with.
No, that seems a little bit light for him.
I think that actually the problem was that the original video weren't that high quality, so it had to be stretched up to a higher format, which just made it lag.
I think he was also chilling. Oh, he's going on to the Inters at lap.
That's very early.
Where is it? Well, it doesn't look ready for Inters. We'll see when he comes out to the pit lane, but I do not think those are going to be the right choice of tyre.
No, clearly not, but I think it was a thing.
Oh, this is the point where Stealing just crashed up and...
Oh my god.
Yeah, well, it's...
Okay. So, we have a blue flag for somebody trying to get past. I'm guessing that's Armstrong.
That must be Armstrong, since...
But, not giving way to the blue flag, though, so, well, I don't know what's happening here, but your dog should be getting out of the way at this point.
Oh, and there is no hidden.
And he
cuts
him off. So,
there was clearly no hidden in these tires. If you are looking at the rear tires, they are
completely...
And he loses part of his front wing, so that's his advantage gone if he had any.
And
here comes Stelling, and... Well, luckily he runs wide, but Stelling looks like he pushed him there. But,
I think so.
Really, well, Stelling had no choice.
Yeah,
and here we go again.
Here we see it. And he actually just... He couldn't do
that
anything.
Was a little off contact there.
So
I think the both drivers turning as much as they could, and yeah, seeing here, of course, after the understeer, so... Well, not the understeer, but the OC, and a little bit bummy there, but nothing will get any penalty for that. And of course, that we are with Yoda again here at lap 13, and taking this can a little bit of weird, I think.
I think it's the tires he's struggling with grip, and he lost part of the front.
Yeah,
one, so.
Of course, he lost the top blade. Yeah.
And here he have the blue flag again from... I wonder who that is.
Flag, and he cuts
does
him off.
Let him pass. What the...
Wow,
that was
son
of more.
He was a fourth.
Who's this coming
up? Another blue flag.
Another blue flag, and he should... This is border disqualification for another guy.
That's
badass,
badass
Joe.
Yeah, if you saw, he's a right front tire. Well, actually logging up at that corner.
Obviously, just nice to point out... Oh, and it was a loose connection to that Irish guy's internet.
Sadly,
his internet, obviously not very good. But nice to point out that badass Joe moving to a permanent spot.
Oh!
A Lotus.
And there goes the entire front wing.
He's obviously going to pit now, and I don't expect him to come out on Inters.
Well, we will see.
He's selecting Inters, so... Interesting choice. He obviously feels like there's enough grip.
Well, it's going to be funny to... Oh, he can actually break down to that con. That was impressive to see.
So obviously the Inters getting into temperature now.
No,
maybe.
Well, yeah, we will see, but it's also I think the guys was telling him, well, it's not Inters.
It's too early.
Yeah, it's too early to shift on the Inters. Because of the temperatures, but of course it's the driver's choice. What size he will go on, so the other guys can tell him what to do. So
Well, he took a chance in hoping that he would ride and then he would have an advantage over the rest of the field.
Yeah, and that is of course. Great by the driver, but sometimes you mentioned and he got past, or well, Wallach's getting past him.
Yeah, I think that was a lap.
Yeah,
yep.
Yeah.
I think he's down on one lap.
Yeah,
and there's another car coming behind him
it
as well.
It seems like Jorak loved the blue flags in this race and a little bit leg up.
Oh,
and he's battling with Warlock.
So Warlock's is on the
intermediate
as well. Can't be that bad. Oh.
Well, I'm not getting this. Why Yodok are battling with these car when he are mean to let them pass? We actually saw a little.
Actually, it looks like he's faster than.
Oh, he got a penalty.
And he's got a penalty, but really, this should be a disqualification right now.
And the penalty weren't even for ignoring the blue flag; it was for causing the collision.
Yeah, Yodok loses a place there.
As we also saw at Yellers, it was on the red tires. If you guys was seeing that, he was on the wet tires.
Yeah.
It's recording to a Vice guy now, but clearly some miscommunication. Okay,
so clearly it looks like it's time for the it looks like it's in the crossover point between wets and intermediates, because Vice Guy's tires are not overheating.
It's time to make way for the faster.
But we can see they're starting to lose grip, but they might just be damaged. And we can see they're overheating a bit in the front right.
Yeah, it's that seems a little bit odd, because it's not that time we get stressed
the
most.
Pits.
Can we make the pit entrance right this time?
Yeah, clearly.
Hit the wall this time.
Yeah, but like also seeing the tire wear was actually a little bit there, so
probably going for intermediates.
Yeah.
So is he going for intermediates or is he going for wet?
Oh dear.
I'm not sure if that was the tires he wanted, but it's the tires he got.
As we saw, the wet tires were starting to overheat, so it would just be silly to keep in wet tires just for one.
Are we going
I
to see now?
He was telling that he was not mentioned to put on the wet tires, but the pit crew just forced him to do that. Well, of course, that is of course bad for the driver, and clearly he needs to talk to the mechanics and the pit crew.
Here we can see Vasco again at the end of lap 15, and we can see again the right side of the tires is completely overheating, and this time I hope for him
when he's braking, overheating there when he brakes, but
there's a Ferrari in the entrance.
And he goes into the wall.
Oh, and he actually lost
and he blocks the Ferrari.
Oh, well, that is
he actually gained a place on that.
That is madness in the pit lane. That is for sure madness.
Let's see who's gonna get first out of the corner.
Let's get the first pit stop here.
Aye.
Okay, so obviously they're changing the wing, but can they get it out first?
5.6. I think the Ferrari had a broken wing as well.
Yes.
And you saw so AMG in the pit too. That was AMG pitting too.
Yeah.
It was Mercedes.
So I'm having a bit of problems following where everybody is during this race, but it looks like Winters has kept his lead.
Yeah, I think so then, but we'll hopefully cut to a syndicate again soon so we can get something info about that. Of course, we are cutting to Vasca again at lap 17, so...
Oh, I think it's stealing who's behind him, because Zach did participate in this race.
Yeah, he was getting some...
He had some problems with his...
Deer.
Yeah, it was actually like a deer. He couldn't control it and the horns spraked off, so...
Yeah, that's a good way to say that, yeah. Of course, when you have problems with your steering, you can't really do very much, so you obviously have to say that you can't race.
Yeah, sadly, but hopefully he will come again and try with us. Next time.
So, but, four laps to go. We've got quite a non-interesting race on our hands, because everybody's separated by at least a second to everybody else.
Yeah, then the minimap are also showing that. So, I think the guys was having a really tough race to holding the car on the track and not spin around like some of the guys we have seen have done. Because it's a difficult track to get right in the wets.
Yeah, and we can see here Vice actually used some curse to try and get rid of the Fortuna coming in from behind.
See, that is a little bit odd when he will probably, as we see now here, getting blue flags, so why should he use the curse if
he is going to let him pass?
I think he was going to...
He's in the ground.
He's going wide. Let's see. Stealing almost...
That was very close.
Stealing clearly didn't realize that Vice was going wide.
But also, something to notice is that the tires are not heating up.
Yeah, I think the track is a little bit awkward after cutting to Steel K and seeing the panel view.
You see Vice going wide to make some space and Steel almost hit him.
Oh. That was a very close pass. But I actually think that Steel K was misjusting and hoping that Vice guy will go close to the corner as well, of course, cutting to
left.
So Winters has won the race quite comfortably.
Yeah. Of course, guys got a lap. Well, the back marker said so.
You can see half the track at lap 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 cars got ours.
Yeah.
Yeah. And obviously
struggling a little bit.
Yeah.
I think he's just trolling around because he got such a huge lead down to the next place.
Yeah. Well, of course he is over the finish line there, and of course here we got the race results.
So
well done.
We've got Son of Mole still at the top of the table, but Stelling DK only 3 points behind. Winter is only 8 points behind, so we've got an absolute treat as a championship battle.
And that's it for tonight. Thank you for watching.